Hey guys, welcome to Effortless Code Learning. I hope you are doing well. In this video, let's learn how to remove image background using Flutter. So let's begin. Here I have already created this UI. Here I have added these 4 icon buttons. These first 2 icon buttons to select image from gallery and camera using image picker. If you don't know about image picker, I have already created video on it. You can watch that video for more detail. Its link is mentioned in the description as well as on I button. This third icon button we will be using to remove the background of the selected image. This fourth icon button we will be using to store the removed background image on the local file storage. Now let's quickly look at this UI. Here on click of this first 2 icon button, I will be calling getImage method. I will be passing image source. It can be gallery or camera. Using image picker, we can select the image from gallery and camera. This selected image path will be stored inside this image path variable. Likewise, this selected image will be stored inside this image file variable. And we will be using these 2 variables to remove the image background. So as soon as the image selected using this image picker, this image will be shown here. And on click of this third icon button, that is to remove the background, background of this image will be removed and the process image will be shown here. To remove image background, I will be using remove.bg REST API. First of all, let's create another class which we'll call remove.bg API. Here I will name it as API client. Here let's name this class as API client. Now inside this API client class, let's create remove.bg API method. It will be async method and it will return uint8list type value. Let's pass image path as a parameter to this method. Here let's import HTTP package. Now let's create multi-part request as we have to send file to this remove.bg API. First parameter to this method is HTTP method. We need to specify here post method. And second parameter is HTTP endpoint URL. So let's specify remove.bg API URL. Now let's assign this multi-part request object to request variable. Now let's add this image path in the request. So here we are passing this image against this image file parameter to this remove.bg API. Now along with this file, we need to pass API key. So first of all, we need to generate API key from remove.bg site. So first of all, you need to have your account created here on remove.bg site. Once your account is created and you log in to this site, go to Tools and API menu. Once you clicked on Tools and API menu, here this API and command line option will be shown. Now click to this API and command line option. You will see few more options like to remove background using API call and remove background using command line. So we need to click on remove background using API call. This another page is open. Here you can get API key. So let's click on get API key. Now this API key dashboard is open. Let's click on new API key button. Here we can specify any name for this API key. So I will specify remove.bg app. Let's click on create API key. API key is created. Let's copy this API key and let's click on the save changes button. This API key is created here. Now let's use the copied API key inside the code. Here you can see I am passing this API key to this API call using X API key parameter. Now let's invoke send method on this request object. This will send actual request to this remove.bg API and let's get the response from this send method. So I will copy this response inside this response object. Here we will check response status first. Means request is processed successfully and we have got the removed background image. Else we might have got the error, so let's throw the exception in case of error. So I am mentioning here status code in the exception message. Now in case we got the success response, then we need to get the process image from the response. Here I will get the process image using this response object. Here to get the file from the response, we need to call PromStream method on this HTTP response class. And then parameter to this method, we need to specify this response object. Now we have got file from the response. Now let's return uint8list object from this image. To return uint8list object, I will be using body bytes property. Now our API code is ready. Let's call this method from this main.dart file. So on click of this delete button, we need to call this API. Here we will call API client.remove.bg API method. And we will be passing this image path as a parameter to this method. And let's assign the return value to this image file variable. And below this, let's call set state for state change. One thing I forgot to mention here, to call this remove.bg API, I will be using this HTTP package. Also, I need to specify internet permission inside android-manifest.xml. Likewise, you can specify internet permission for iOS. Now our API code is ready. Let's test. So here I will select image from a gallery. Now let's click on this remove background icon button. So here you can see background is removed from this image. Only the bird is displayed. Other background is removed. Now background is getting removed. Now let's store this image on local file storage. To store the image on local file storage, I will be using screenshot package, and along this package I will be using path provider and permission handler package. Let's download these dependencies. To store this image on local file storage, I need to wrap this image widget inside screenshot widget. Here we need to pass controller to this screenshot widget. So first of all, let's create screenshot controller. Let's move this child property below this controller property as it is giving warning. Now we have wrapped this image widget inside this screenshot widget. Now let's write method which will be called on save button, and it will store the process image on local file storage. It will be async method. First of all, get the file storage permission. If permission is not provided, then inside this if condition, let's get the permission. Now below this if block, if the permission is provided, let's store the file on local file storage. Now get the app directory path, and inside this directory we will be storing the image. So for that, first of all get the file name. So we will be creating file name using datetime.now method. So it will be unique. And we will keep it extension as png. Now to store the image on local file storage, let's call capture and save method on screenshot controller object. So here we have passed directory in the first parameter, and then we need to specify file name. So here for this file name property, we will specify file name that we just created above. Now our code to save image on local file storage is ready. Now let's call this method from this save icon button. Now we need to specify storage permission inside this android-manifest.xml. Likewise, you can specify storage permission for iOS. Now let's reload the application again and check. Now let's select the image from gallery. Now let's click on this remove background button. Here background is removed from this image. Now let's click on save button. Now permission pop-up came up. Let's allow this permission. Now it is stored on local file storage. Let's check. Here you can see this remote background image is stored on the local file storage. That's all for this video. I hope this video was really helpful. Like this, if you really enjoyed watching, and do consider subscribing my channel. You can also follow me on Instagram. I will see you in next video. Until next time, stay tuned. Thanks for watching the video.